Okay, so I will start from scratch. So now we are going to start on the Sterling B2B Integrator. Coming to the Sterling B2B Integrator, what are the industry other B2B products? First thing will be like Axway, Amtrix, and Datapower XP62. Coming to all the leader will be in the market. Okay. Okay, now what we are going to learn in the Sterling B2B. So, what is the Sterling B2B Integrator? And what is mean by graphical processor modular?
Okay.
What is mean by DPML and XPath, and how you can use the GPM? How you can troubleshoot the things? And how you can use the service management and integrator mapping, IPO mapping, tracking health, and some best practices. Okay. So what is mean by exactly Sterling B2B Integrator? It's like mainly we can use the Sterling B2B in the end-to-end enterprise integration services. For example, it's a B2B product. So I have a multiple partners sending XML message, and another partner is trying to understand, it will understand only flat files. So the integrator, we have to convert that to XML message as a flat file understandable to the partner. Then you send this flat file to the partner. Then, so the conversion of everything will be taken care of by B2B systems. So again, it will be like high security involved in here, AS2 protocols, as well as SSL implementation, SFTP implementation, SSH implementation as well for the partners. It will support now mostly so many protocols and so many message formats and everything. And there is a, if you hear about the tool of the WTX, Web Spear Transformation Extender, so you can easily integrate with the WTX tool to the Sterling B2B Integrator as well.
Sterling, okay.
So what are the features of the Sterling B2B Integrator? Simplified management and consistent integrity deployment methodology and end-to-end process, reduce operational cost, and increase operational efficiencies, improve customer satisfaction, increase revenues. And coming to the user interfaces, how many user interfaces are available here? One is administrative interface and Sterling B2B map editor and graphical processor modular. So now you are seeing the administrative interface. This is the administrative interface. So left side will be the administration menu, administration console. And then we will go with the map editor. This is the internal, if you install the Sterling B2B Integrator, you will get the map editor software as well. So you have to install this map editor software, then you have to download, you have to install based on your particular support packs. For example, I'm working on the SIFT message format. So you have to install on top of map editor, have to install the SIFT message format. Then only you, that message formats will support, and you can convert one message to another message. You have to install that particular message fix packs to the map editor. Okay. So it will be recognized by the in this map editor. And coming to the next GPM. So this is the graphical processor modular. Here, left side, if you see the all the nodes, small actions are there, that those actions we will call as a stencils. Each stencil have particular purpose, and whenever you are creating any flow, that flow, it will start from the start stencil and end with end stencil. So start will be one and end will be one. So in between, you can create a number of design and flow or based on your business requirement. So under the, what is the whenever you are drawing the and flow these diagrams, and inside the back end of the Sterling, it will generate the BPL code, BPL code. So you can, while deploying to the server, you can deploy either BPL code or it looks like XML message only, XML structure only. Either you can deploy the graphical model, .bp format as well in the server. Okay, if you are very well on the BPL process, BPL structure, then it will be good, very good to understand inside the, you can directly normally to navigate in the changes in the flow level, and you can directly change the code level as well.
Okay.
And coming to the administrative interface, here multiple tab sections are there. Here one is the business process, one is the trading partners and deployment and invoicing operations second. Accounts will be user section, business process will be while you want to create a BP and you want to deploy the BP and you want to start the BP, you want to set the BP based on all the BP workflow, whatever you previously created by GPM, those BPs you will configure and you will execute in the business process. And trading partners, you will create a like based on the partners, inbound partner, outbound partner and everything.
Okay.
And each partner have one unique ID that is called like unique for the partner.
Mm-hmm.
And the deployments will be deployment and the operation account, these are the things for the as of now.
Rao, who is
later point, 1 minute.
Mm.
Okay, this is the like whenever you are opening business process, you will see the manager. There you can download the graphical processor modular software. Mm-hmm. There, because whenever you are opening the business process admin console, so that moment it has, whenever you are installing the Sterling B2B software, mm-hmm. they have the Java 1.6 some supported version.
Mm-hmm.
Version, this business process, those softwares will be automatically downloaded from the administration console, then you have to install, then automatically it will be pop up, then you have to work on that one.
Okay.
Whenever you created a simple BP, the extension of the file will be saved as a .bp, and the .bp file you can't read in the notepad anything, but if you once import it to the tool GPM editor, that can be read by Excel BPL format. So there you can see the raw code of the your flow.
Okay.
So whenever you open your BP as a set screen, so you will ask the most of these names, business process name and status, start date from, start date to. If you click on the advanced search options, these options will ask location, business process ID, system business process, status, start date from, start date to. These are the where you are searching for the BP in the administrative console.
Okay. Okay.
So in the here, whenever you are clicking in the deployment section, you can find the services. Services, schedules, maps, standards, extended rule libraries. Okay, each purpose, each one have their own purpose. Okay, services, it will be install and configure the services for the Sterling B2B integrator, and the schedulers, it can allows the locate the configuration of the certain services, adapters, and if you want to start the business process, run particular specific time, and you want to delete the schedule whenever you want to do the business process, it will work as a schedule like that. And maps, and you have to work, you have to create multiple maps using a map editor. Then you have to use this map function. You have to import the map to the Sterling B2B in the deployment section. You have to configure the maps to the particular BPs. And standards, whatever I told you, right? For example, you want to download a particular, you want to, you are now, I'm working on a EDIFACT messages. That's a different message format structure. Mm-hmm. And XFOL messages. So right now in my map editor, I did not install the EDIFACT message structure. So mm-hmm. that moment I have to install the EDIFACT standard, then only that map editor can recognize that standard. Then only you can work on the EDIFACT messages. Okay. These are the standards and extended rule libraries. So you want to configure the particular extended rule libraries from the third party libraries, then you have to configure those libraries in the extended rule library section. And one more tab will be XSLT. XSLT is a style sheet language because the BP, all the BPs are like in the backend code is generating on the BPL code and it looks like XML only. Do you want to transform that XML input message or output message? You want to do the manipulation of anything? You require some style sheet language that is called XSLT. And schemas also there.
Okay.
Schemas like schemas, it will be validate the incoming message, and for the, we will use for the validation of the incoming XML messages. Mailbox. Mailbox option allows you to organize and store and manage trading partners' document and transactions.
Okay.
Resource manager allows you to create and locate resource tags and import or export resources. We will use for this resource tags.
Okay.
Adapter utilities. One more option is there, adapter utilities.
Uh-huh.
Adapter utilities allows to create your DTDs means schema. And for any external system, existing system or Siebel system or whatever it is, those adapters you can configure here. And next one is SSH, secure shell key. And whenever you want to integrate with SFTP protocols, you have to configure the, your SSH protocols here.
Okay.
And web service. And you can implement like all the web services here as well. Web services now only you require the visual. And visual contain the input message, output message, validation, and the port number and operations.
Okay.
Can you see this graphical processor modular?
Yeah.
So here, this is screen we will call as a stencils. Okay. These are all things are we will call as a stencils. And this is we will call as a title bar. This top one and the menus file and these things options, these things are we will call as a menu bar.
Okay.
And, whenever you see the magnifier symbol and file output, those that is we will call as a toolbar. And this this flow you are seeing, that is we will call as a workspace.
Mm-hmm.
And here this is in the left side, you can see left side top down area. Mm-hmm. That is what we will call as a navigation panel.
Okay.
And this is called like a particular stencils object. You can configure those. This is another area, edit service editor, you can say, stencil editor, you can say.
Okay.
If you see in the options, under the options, multiple operate multiple tabs, sub-tabs will be there. One is a general tab and another one is source manager. The source manager, you can see the your code as a BPL format, BPL code. And that is the main thing. And whenever you are opening a tools, in the tools section, you will find the rule manager and source manager and subflow. If you want to create a subflow, under the tools, you have to create a subflow. Those options will be available under the tools.
Okay.
Can you share me that the slide is the slides?
Okay, using this graphical processor modular, you can integrate with the SAP suite adapter and Oracle e-business suite adapter and Oracle e-business suite manage message services. Coming to the application, IBM application, IBM Sterling Connect Direct, it's like a very secure file transfer protocol, CD protocol we will call, and in the Unix server, and Sterling information broker, Sterling Zentron server. Sterling Zentron server is like a core product of the Sterling B2B. Previously we will call it Sterling Zentron.
Okay.
And coming to the all the stencils, we have like start stencils and end stencil. Stencil, okay. Start and stencil. The start stencil activity indicates the beginning of the business process. Every business process model must begin with start. Okay.
Yeah.
End stencil. End activity indicates the end of the business process. Every business process model must finish with end. And on fault group. On fault group activity is a subflow. Whenever you want to create a subflow, you have to use this on fault group. And all start. All start. This all start activity is a parent activity in a business process. If you want to distribute your all the services to the particular flows, you have to create all start. And again, after the end of the all start, again, all end will be there.
Okay.
And choice start. This choice start is a parent activity for the business process. If this choice start indicates a decision and run one child activity as a result of this decision, like if or else condition, like if there is a choice, if yes or no condition kind of thing, that moment you will use this choice start. Okay. And choice and also same thing, and sequence start. Sequence start activity is a parent activity in a business process.
Okay.
Whenever you are using this sequence start activity, why we will use this sequence start activity, and it will, whenever you are creating a sequence start, the series of all the activities in order to, it will work as a series sequence mode actually.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to assign particular name for the property editor for the sequence start. And sequence end also will be there whenever you are creating a start activity, and you have to mention the end activity as well.
Okay.
And assign. Assign activity, like you are defining a particular value to the particular field, assign variable. So this assign stencil, you have to set a particular value to the your business process. Fixed value, like a static value, you can say.
Okay.
Consume activity reads a specific input message and store that message into a business process data. That is the main purpose. This consume activity will read the message from the input message and store into the BP data, business process data.
Okay.
Produce stencil. It will generate a message from the business process and it will deliver to the particular activity. Span. It runs as a nested business process. If you are like, if you want to call multiple BPs, that moment you will use this span.
Okay.
Join stencil. And whenever you want to merge the results of the particular business process, you have to use the join.
Okay.
Repeat. 1 minute. Hello.
Yeah.
Join activity merge for the, there is a two nested business process are there. You want to merge those two business process and a single business process. You have to use join stencil. And repeat activity, if you want to do multiple times of get the data from the BPML operation, you have to use the repeat operation, repeat stencil.
Okay.
What is mean by Sterling B2B Integrator and what are the graphical GUI tools are there and what are the stencils are there? Just very high level we covered.
Okay.